I'm Steve Tarano with Ask a Real Expert. SureDog is asking about negative calorie foods. We've all heard that carrots and celery and broccoli and cabbage take more calories to digest than they contain. And he asks, is that true? And do I have to take into consideration my fruits and vegetable totals when I'm totaling up my daily calories? Well, let's think about this from a logical standpoint. Number one, fruits and vegetables contain a lot of fiber, and we don't have the digestive enzymes to digest the calories in fibers. So that's why fruits and vegetables make us use the restroom, and we don't absorb a lot of calories from them, because again, we don't have the enzymes to digest those calories. We're not cows. Cows get lots of nutrients from grass because they can digest those calories. We can't. Second thing we want to think of is, if it takes us about 15 minutes to walk a mile, and we only burn 70 calories moving our entire body a mile, do you think you utilize a lot of calories moving a bunch of chewed up food from here out down there? You know, not really. Peristalsis doesn't take a huge amount of calories, and besides, it's all downhill. You know, gravity's doing a lot of the work. Now, if this were meats, I would say yes, we do burn more calories digesting meats, but certainly not more than they contain. And with regards to fruits and vegetables, again, you're not going to lose weight by eating them because of the quote-unquote negative calorie effect on them, or the fact that you're burning calories by digesting them or moving them through your digestive tract. You're going to lose weight by eating fruits and vegetables simply because instead of eating higher calorie foods, you're substituting them with lower calorie foods, fruits and vegetables, so you're not taking in as many calories. But these are some simple things that if you step back and think about it, you go, well, God, that does kind of make sense. 70 calories to walk a mile, that's a lot of walking, not quite the same as digesting some stuff. And yeah, digestion takes more than an hour, but with regards to using or incorporating the calorie totals from fruits and vegetables, I don't even worry about it because I don't think many people eat that many fruits and vegetables. If you were going to be eating tons of olives, which is where olive oil comes from, or avocados, which are very high, I believe they're 100% fat, or you're eating tons of nuts, peanuts, people think they're a great source of protein. They're not. They're a shitty source of protein, plus they're 80 to 85% fats. If you were eating those foods, I'd say, yeah, you should factor that in. But regular things, you know, salads, broccolis, cauliflower, apples, oranges, bananas, how much of that stuff are people really eating? And it's not necessarily the fruits and vegetables that are troublesome, it's the stuff you put on them. Cheese sauces, ranch dressing, chocolate. Those are the things that you have to worry about. I'm Steve Tarano. Train smart, train hard.